The healthcare sector is growing rapidly with a growth rate of 5.3%. The global healthcare revenue generated by biomedical device industry is more than $500 billion. $500 billion. This is higher than the combined GDP of many developing countries put together. Now, it is almost impossible to imagine healthcare in the absence of biomedical devices. But unfortunately, they are also the leading cause of hospital-acquired infections. Every year, these infections affect 2 million people, leading to 90,000 deaths in the United States alone. For a quick reference, this is equivalent to a sold-out game at Sanford Stadium. The global figures can be even more horrifying, especially in the developing countries with poor healthcare facilities. The current medical treatments rely heavily on the use of antibiotics. But the issue of antibiotic resistance raises an alarming concern. So let us understand in layman term what is antibiotic resistance. Antibiotic resistance is a defense mechanism in bacteria that eliminates or reduces the effectiveness of antibiotics. So why is it easy for a bacteria to develop resistance? The answer lies in the way antibiotics are produced in nature. Antibiotics are produced by one kind of bacteria to kill another kind of bacteria via a very specific mechanism in order to survive. Since antibiotics belong to the microbial system, it is much easier for a bacteria to understand its killing mechanism, evolve into a smarter form, and develop resistance. And when this happens, even the last resort antibiotic, colistin, is rendered ineffective. You might want to know how fast can a bacteria develop resistance. According to a recent study done by MIT US and Technion Israel, bacteria can develop resistance within 11 hours of antibiotic exposure. Now, this is a more serious problem than it sounds. Since a bacteria can divide into billions within hours, this means that despite all these lethal side effects, you have to continuously take antibiotics. And that's the reason why doctors prescribe antibiotics for a longer period of time. Health agencies have warned that by 2050, antibiotic resistance will kill 10 million people every year. This is higher than the deaths caused by cancer. Jim O'Neill, the United Kingdom Treasury Secretary, has warned that this will lead to a global loss of $100 trillion. $100 trillion. Due to the seriousness of the problem, G20 countries have been appealed to come together and fight this problem. Now, based on all these facts and figures, one thing is very, very clear, that we need an alternative today. Now the question is, do we have an alternative? And the answer is no. If my smile is disappointing you, then please wait a while. I'm talking about nitric oxide, also known as NO. I'm talking about nitric oxide, also known as NO, or simply NO. So NO was widely regarded as an air pollutant, but this changed in 1992 when the title Molecule of the Year was given to it by Journal Science. 6 years later, in 1998, it was the topic of a Nobel Prize. NO is a cellular signaling molecule produced by trillions of cells in human body that can fight infection, but it can do much more than that. NO is very versatile. NO can help in wound healing. NO has a key role to play in cancer, diabetes, and even sexual health. Surprise? Research has shown that NO-based therapies are more effective in treating male erectile dysfunction as compared to popular Viagra. I can see some people are taking more interest in my talk now. I'm telling you guys, nitric oxide can solve literally any problem. Scientists like me are now leveraging on this magical molecule, keeping a sense of urgency in mind. We are making biomedical devices that can release nitric oxide the way body releases nitric oxide when it comes in contact with heat, moisture, and metal ions. Since heat, moisture, and metal ions are readily available in human body, anode-releasing material are an excellent candidate to make biomedical devices such as stents, catheters, glucose sensors, condoms, and artificial skin. We have tested these materials on most prevalent bacteria, including E. coli and Staph aureus, and our results are astonishing. We have shown that anode-releasing material can kill more than 99.9% bacteria. And unlike antibiotic that acts via a very specific killing mechanism over a long period of time, nitric oxide has a short half-life of fewer than 5 seconds. And it acts very non-specifically. For instance, NO can kill or disrupt the outer membrane of bacteria. NO can denature the bacterial protein, or it can degrade the bacterial DNA. Due to its short half-life, rapid action, and non-specific killing mechanism, NO does not give bacteria enough time and opportunity to understand its killing mechanism and develop resistance against it. We have tested our material for storage stability, and we have shown that NO-releasing material are stable for more than 6 months when kept at room temperature. My research thus far has resulted in 15 publications in peer-reviewed journals. Due to the high commercialization potential, I have also filed 7 patents in USPTO, and these applications covers food packaging materials, wound dressings, condom technologies, device top coats, and artificial skin. Now, all these patents and publications, they are good for me. But you might be more interested in knowing whether it is safe or not to use anode-releasing material. Well, there is another good news for you. We have tested anode-releasing material on human and animal cells, and we have found them to be 100% viable. Now, this is awesome. This means that anode can kill more than 99.9% bacteria. This means that NO does not give bacteria to develop resistance. And this also means that NO is 100% safe. Isn't it great? These findings are very promising and will open new doors of opportunities in the field of biomedical engineering. But we cannot neglect the fact that there is a lot that we need to learn about nitric oxide research. At this stage of my professional career, I want to invest my future in NO research and be at the forefront of this groundbreaking technology. Our research has been funded by major organizations such as National Institute of Health, Center for Disease Control and Prevention, and Department of Defense. In collaboration with Vet School at UGA and Department of Defense, and we are currently doing animal trials, and our results are very, very positive. And we are as excited as you might be now to ultimately do clinical trials and bring this technology to market. Now, based on years of my industrial experience and academic experience working with a great team in the University of Georgia, I have come to the realization that nitric oxide, or NO, is going to be the next generation therapeutics that will help us make safer biomedical devices, that will help us prevent implant failure, and that will help us overcome the problem of antibiotic resistance. Now, before I leave the stage, my question to you is, are you ready to say yes to no?